overwhelming. But I can tell you, there's nothing to worry about. You'll be fine. So let's just focus on getting you through your first meeting, okay? Let's see. First, there's an introductory greeting from the company that I'm supposed to read. It's kind of a legal thing, you know. Welcome to Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, the magical place for kids and grown-ups alike, where fantasy and fun come to life. Fazbear Entertainment is not responsible for damage to property or person. Upon discovering that damage or death has occurred, a missing person report will be filed within 90 days to as soon as property and premises have been thoroughly cleaned and bleached and the carpets have been replaced. Blah, blah, blah. Now, that might sound bad, I know, but there's really nothing to worry about. The animatronic characters here do get a bit quirky at night, but do I blame them? No. If I were forced to sing those same stupid songs for 20 years and I never got a bath, I'd probably be a bit irritable at night too. So remember, these characters hold a special place in the hearts of children if you show them a little respect, right? Okay. So just be aware, the characters do tend to wander a bit. They're left in some kind of free roaming mode at night. Something about their servos locking up, they get turned off for too long. They used to be allowed to walk around during the day, too, but then there was the bite of 87. Yeah. It's amazing that the human body can live without the frontal lobe, you know? Now, concerning your safety, the only real risk to you as a night watchman here, if any, is the fact that these characters, if they happen to see you after hours, probably won't recognize you as a person. They'll most likely see you as a metal endoskeleton without a costume. Now, since that's against the rules here at Freddy Fazbear's Pizza, they'll probably try to forcefully stuff you inside a Freddy Fazbear suit. Now, that wouldn't be so bad if the suits themselves weren't filled with cross beams, wires, and animatronic devices, especially around the facial area. So you can imagine how having your head forcefully stuffed inside one of those could cause a bit of discomfort and death. The only part of you that would likely see the light of day again would be your eyeballs and teeth pop out the front of the mask. Yeah, they don't tell you these things if you're dying either. But hey, first thing to breathe. I'll chat with you tomorrow. Check those cameras and remember to close the doors only if absolutely necessary. Conserve power. Alright, good night.
Emphasize the importance of using your door light. There are blind
spots in your camera view, and those blind spots have to be right outside the door. So if you can't find someone or someone on your camera, be sure to check the door light. You might only have a few seconds to react, but not that you would be in any danger, of course. I'm not implying that. Also, check on the person's pilot code.
Everything under control. Talk to you soon. Mm-hmm.